家好，我是 Esther Leung 江梁以恩，文化更新研究中心的拓展经理。我会同大家分享我在文根里面如何参与和原住民同行的服侍和事工。今年三月，我们举办了一个共五堂的免费粤语主题讲座，就是让加拿大华人可以更加了解到原住民的惨痛历史和和解历程。讲座名为 Eagles Rising 展英计划，议题包括原住民民族的基本认识，详细的去讲解原住民寄宿学校惨痛的历史，亦都会讲到例如乜嘢是原住民保留区、酋长的制度或者是土地管理的政策。最后亦都有同大家介绍了几位鼓舞人心的原住民领袖。我们举办这个活动亦都是回应 Truth and Reconciliation Commission 里面的94项的 Calls to Action，是对所有加拿大人的呼吁，一起去参与和解行动。其中一项就是对移民提供关于原住民的教育资料。其实很多海外的华人移民是没有机会学习到关于原住民任何的历史，以及他们今天面对所有的种种问题。所以我们民间都希望藉着这个机会，可以给华人的移民去更加了解原住民的经历，这样我们才懂得怎样去关心他们。另外，我们作为移民在加拿大其实得到了很多的祝福，但是原住民在过去从加拿大立国之前一直到现在，因为殖民主义的政策，有种族歧视，到后期寄宿学校制度，其实他们受了很大的创伤，伤口还是流血。所以我们理应是尊重和关注加拿大的第一民族。作为华人，其实我们会不会可能在当中做一个和解使者的角色呢？在温哥华，民间从2016年开始有资助本地一个基督教的慈善机构，叫做 Vancouver Urban Ministries， 简称 VUM。 当中民间有资助一些有学习需要的原住民学生，令到他们有机会去接受 VUM 一个很高质素的补习课程。藉着这个合作的关系，我们也有关心这些学生家庭的其他需要。例如在圣诞节的时候，我也会去帮忙组织这个 Christmas Hamper 送赠圣诞节礼物篮的项目，可以送给 VUM 里面很多有需要的原住民和低收入家庭。尤其是在疫情里面，上年的圣诞节真的对低收入的家庭是非常不容易，希望在困难里面可以带给他们一点的爱心和鼓励。在今年的六月，民间也会赠送80本我自己今年出版的儿童图书，叫做 Wonderfully Made 奇妙的杰作，去送给 VUM 里面服侍的学生。在书里面我分享到我自己从香港移民到加拿大小时候面临的各种的困难和经历，例如有种族歧视和如何去适应新文化所面临的挑战。在故事里面我也有分享到我大学时期认识了原住民的朋友，以及聆听他们在寄宿学校里面的经历。希望这本书能够帮到小朋友去学习，去做一个有同理心和善良的人，同时也都懂得珍惜和欣赏自己的文化。因为疫情的关系，已经做了13年的 Project Shine 阳光计划项目，就是我们每一年的夏天会带领一班北美年轻人去中国山区教英文的这个项目都要取消。不过上一年的夏天呢，我们也都同 VUM 举办了一个免费的夏令营，名为天生有型 Born to Shine Summer Camp，目的是帮助本地有需要的低收入家庭和孩子。今年我们希望继续再次举办这个儿童夏令营，我们现在也都有需要是招募年轻人和义工去帮忙带领这个夏令营。如果大家有兴趣，或者你身边有年轻人的可以参与，请和我们的联络。另外，我都想和大家介绍民根今年将于6月22日定为与原住民同行日。今年民根的主题是同行更美，与邻居同行是疫情过后我们最希望能够做到的。由于我们过去几年一直都有关注加拿大原住民在温哥华的需要，而我自己也都有多年来投身关心加拿大原住民的事工，所以民间也都希望透过6月22日的这个与原住民同行日 Eagles Rising Awareness Day， 让更多加拿大华人了解和提高对加拿大原住民的认识，从而能够用爱心以行动去爱我们的邻舍，与他们一起的同行。但是为什么会是6月22日呢？因为之前那一日就是这个叫做全国原住民日， National Indigenous People's Day， 所以我们就挑选了6月22号去举办我们这个活动。详细资料可以在我们的网页去看。
我们邀请了一位温哥华原住民 Mary Fontaine 牧师，他也是我的朋友，他是 Hummingbird Ministries 的 Executive Director。 他们是一个原住民的慈善机构，用音乐、艺术和表演来带来医治。 Mary 会从一个原住民的角度和我们分享他对于文化更生将会在6月22日定立为与原住民同行日的看法。
Dance and Authentic。 Hello my friends, I'm Reverend Mary Fontaine, an ordained minister of the Presbyterian Church in Canada. I'm originally from the prairies, from Saskatchewan. I'm Nahio, we call ourselves, and Canadians call us Cree. I'm honored to be here today, and I'm very, very honored that Esther has taken the time to work with us and to create awareness about the Indigenous history in Canada. And I'm also so grateful to the Chinese community for your willingness to learn and to understand what really happened to Indigenous people in Canada and what still is happening here. In spite of almost 500 years of being oppressed by European colonizers, we are still here. And I am honored that the Chinese community, through the Eagles Rising Awareness Day, hosted by the CRRS, is aiming to honor our people by raising awareness of our resilience and our history. Thank you. Due in large part to Canada's negligence in making this tragic history known, the legacy continues with new Canadians. For example, in my ministry, we have children who are oppressed by and bullied by other kids, in this case, brown kids, who tell them, get out of here, go home, go back to your own country, because they have no idea who we are or what the history of Canada is all about. Often we talk about eagles, and eagles are very much respected in our cultures. Eagles fly high, and eagles don't quit flying. They will keep on trying to fly, even if they're wounded. In the same way, our people are very wounded. We're still here, somehow by the spirit, the great spirit who sustains us. And I think it's also to do with our worldview. Our worldview is about love and about peace. We talk about the great tree of peace, a vision that our people had through our traditions, that one day the people will make peace with one another, and that all the people will gather under this great tree of peace. The eagle flies high, and we think of the eagle as being next to God, bringing us closer to God, the messenger of God. So there's many different misconceptions about what our people believed. They thought we worshiped the sun. They thought we worshiped the eagle. We worshiped the creator. As my mom used to say, there's only one God, one creator of us all. In the same way, we take example of the eagle. We keep on trying to fly. We don't give up. We know that the creator has the final say in all things. I'm honored that the CRRS, Chinese Day of Honoring Indigenous People, will cover some of the ways that our people continue to be oppressed by historical instruments of colonization. As I said before, I'm very, very honored by your community, Esther, by you and the work that you do. We see signs of hope, and we continue to pray that the Great Spirit will indeed bring healing to all our nations, and that indeed we can gather under that great tree of peace. Hi, hi, Nanaskum, Tanan. Hi, thank you.
在这里再一次向大家多谢你们对文化更新研究中心的支持，希望大家对原住民有更多的认识、关心和服侍。在这里我祝福大家有平安和健康的身心灵。